that someone is torn it apart. And she's taken almost all that I've got. But if you want, I'll try to love again. Baby, I'll try to love again, but I know. Cut is the deepest. Baby, I know the first cut is the deepest. 'Cause when it comes to being lucky, she's cursed. When it comes to loving me, she's worse. But when it comes to being loved, she's first. That's how I know the first cut is the
When I was telling a friend about this video and I mentioned it involved an i7 PC, he gasped and said, i7? Whoa, that sounds big. But what he didn't know is that the i7 has been through several generations and has been in production since 2008. And the chip in today's PC is in fact one of those early series Bloomfield chips. To give you an idea of how old this Bloomfield series came out before Gulf Town, Sandy Bridge, Ivy Bridge, Haswell, Broadwell, and now Skylake. So, can an old i7 rig like this act as a modern gaming PC, or should we once and for all retire the belief that the words Core i7 mean government-grade computing and 60fps in every game? Before we jump down to the garage to check out the specs, we're going to of course have to give this PC a clean as it's well due for one. What I recommend for you is to sit back, make a cup of tea or grab a beer if that's more your thing, and enjoy tonight's episode of GreenHamMailbox. Meet the Dell XPS 9100. It was a very, very powerful PC for the time. The 2.6 GHz Core i7-920 processor was top of the line in its day, and the 4 GB of RAM still isn't too bad at all. In terms of storage, we had one 500 GB hard drive for the OS, and a terabyte hard drive for all the other junk. The system would have originally come with something like a Radeon 5870, so this case is more than big enough to accommodate massive cards like the 5870, as well as more adorable little cards like the GTX 750. But what we are using today is the GTX 750 Ti from Gigabyte with a Windforce cooler. This card is a really, really solid low to mid-range performer and should help us figure out whether this old beast can handle some newer games. From a completely objective view, this machine should have no trouble smashing games at 1080p, but let's see how it does in the green marks. In the first test, the Bioshock Infinite Under the Sea and Into the Clouds test, all at high settings at 1080p. Under the Sea, we got 45 FPS at the minimum, 79 at the best, and average of 66, which is perfectly playable. In the clouds, we got 59 at the worst, 92 at the best, and 67 most of the time. Very, very impressive frame rates from that bench. Test 2 is the CSGO Yippee-Ki-Yay motherfucker test. Long name for a really quite small test. All of this was at high settings and 1080p. The frame rate during action was 108 at the worst, 264 at the best, and most of the time 147 FPS. Really, This game isn't that challenging, but if you play CSGO professionally, you know that frame rate is crucial to you winning a match. Test 3, the Far Cry 3 5-minute power fest, all at high settings at 1080p, got us 43 FPS and 57 at the best and 48 most of the time, just chilling in the river. But during Carnage, the frame rate dropped a small amount, not much, but just a little, to 41 FPS at the minimum, 58 at the best, and average of 47. Test number 4, gMod Volvo Madness at the highest settings, 1080p. Going for a stroll, frame rates were, as you would expect from a game of this age, 189 at the minimum. At the max, we were at 297, and most of the time, 253. Crazy high frame rates, but this game is old and not particularly demanding. But when things get interesting is when physics is involved. So with the Volvo-related madness, at a minimum we had 18 FPS, at the max we had 81, and the average of 44. So still very impressive frame rates during Volvo-related madness. Test 5, the Minecraft Build Something and Blow It Up test, all at 16 chunks at the highest settings and 1080p, showed impressive results. In the building section, the minimum was 23 FPS, but that was only when things were being rendered at the start. The max was 229, and most of the time we were at a crystal clear and butter smooth 95 FPS. In the blow up what we've built section, we got 2 FPS at the worst, and 98 at the best, and an average of 62. Very good frame rates, but considering this test is a bit unfair, as every computer of any spec will slow down when you blow something up. So there you are. A classic first-gen i7 Dell like this can absolutely smash games and offer similar performance to machines with modern Core i3 chips or slightly older i5 processors. A Dell like this is also highly upgradable and will make a great choice for those looking to play the latest games on the budget of a next-gen console. And that concludes tonight's episode of GreenHamMailbox. Make sure to subscribe if you enjoy this kind of goofy computer content, and so you can remain updated for when the next video surfaces. In this case, the next episode will likely be a VHS original about a classic failed console. Thanks again for watching, and good night.
Now.
No!
Why not? Fuck! I didn't look around!